Each of us, the whole world over, yearns for two gifts from life. They are the experience of joy and escape from sorrow. These two are invariably linked. We spend most of our time searching for ways to be happy because we know with an unspoken certainty that lasting peace and joy are rightfully ours. We find it hard to settle for less. However, forgetting that this ocean of happiness already lies waiting within, we search vainly outside our true self. We are like the man who is standing knee-deep in a flowing stream, holding out his cup, begging for water. We are like the Siberian musk deer, which spends all of its life searching in vain for the source of this beautiful scent. Only in its last moments does it realize that the sweet smell of musk was all the time coming from its own body. We continue to run after worldly pleasures, even though their attainment brings only a brief flicker of delight. Sometimes we are vaguely aware that our transient happiness will be followed at some time by sorrow. Our melancholy, anger, and despair are but common reactions to the loss of something gained, or the failure to gain something desired. Every desire has the potential to become an addiction. The stronger the addiction, the more sorrow that follows, which in turn increases the desire for more. The descent into misery can be illustrated with the example of fire. At first, the fire of our desire is satisfied with just a few twigs of the sought-after thing. But each time we feed the fire, it grows bigger and hungry for more. We can see from the analogy why happiness in life gets less when we allow more and stronger desires. Real peace, we know, is an absence of all desire. As St. John of the Cross wrote, "In order to arrive at having pleasure in everything, desire pleasure in nothing." Each one of us is addicted in our own unique way to a number of special desires. The sorrows which follow in the wake of each one build up over time into a wall or body of pain. This pain body, as Eckhart Tolle has named it, keeps us away from the heaven within, our source of eternal delight. But the story does not end here. What's important to know is that our unhappiness is a product of a yearning to draw closer to our true self. It's just that we've been facing the wrong way, seeking ever outwards instead of ever inwards. As Henry James wisely said, "The infinite hunger of the soul cannot be satisfied with the things of the senses." With such understanding, a new journey of awakening can begin. The wise ones have told us that pure, lasting, unsullied happiness lies waiting within. Let us seek it. Let us find it. Let us find it.